Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam. Welcome to episode number 27, Moments with the Qur'an. Today's moment comes from Surah Az-Zumar, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. SubhanAllah, this ayah, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the ayah of hope. The scholars of tafsir called this ayah the ayah of hope. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to inform his ummah, inform the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially those who have sort of oppressed themselves. How did they oppress themselves? By not being sinful, but really being sinful. SubhanAllah. Asrafu ala anfusihim. They went over the boundaries in terms of the disobedience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Don't fall into a state of despair with regards to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah. I mean, I don't know how to do justice to this ayah in terms of its translation. Don't fall into despair. Right? Allah isn't saying don't lose hope. He's saying don't fall into despair, meaning you've behaved in such a way that is not a way that brings about loss of hope, but rather brings despair. Allah is saying don't fall into despair with regards to the mercy of Allah. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sins of everyone wholesale, in an instant. This is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will forgive every sin in an instant. SubhanAllah. Innahu huwa al-ghafoor al-raheem. Indeed, he is al-ghafoor. SubhanAllah. The most forgiving, who is perpetual in his forgiving. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is raheem. He is the especially merciful. With a mercy that is for all of his creation and a mercy that is especially for the believers. Innahu huwa al-ghafoor al-raheem. SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we read ayat like this, SubhanAllah, and then also we have narrations that further explain the reality of this ayah. For example, in the Hadith Qudsi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Yabna Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك أنان السماء ثم استغفرت لي لغفرتها لك ولا أبالي. O son of Adam, if you sinned and sinned that your sins filled your atmosphere, it reached the surfaces of the skies. That's how many sins you have. Imagine sinning to the extent that you fill the globe up to the skies. Then Allah says, ثم استغفرت لي. And then you sincerely regretted and turned to Allah and said, Ya Allah, forgive me. Allah says, لغفرتها لك. I will forgive your sins for you. And Allah uses the past tense, which teaches us that this is something confirmed. Allah is not saying, meaning the translation, we said, I will forgive, but it's as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, consider yourself forgiven. I will forgive you in a way that through which I want you to consider yourself forgiven. وَلَا أُبَالِي. And it won't even matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It won't even matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, seek forgiveness in a way that when you get up from the place or you move from the space that you use to ask Allah to forgive you, consider yourself forgiven. If you pass away then, you have nothing to answer for. SubhanAllah, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is highlighting to us his ability to forgive and how merciful he is. He's not saying seek forgiveness and then, you know, carry on, go about your day, you know, worried, has Allah forgiven me? Hasn't He forgiven me? Allah is saying, consider yourself forgiven. And it doesn't even matter to Allah. It's easy for Allah. Allah has created Jannah for you. Allah wants to forgive you. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the lesson of today's moment. Now, this is not a license, brothers and sisters in Islam, just that no one gets the wrong understanding, to do sin. Because shaitan will come to you and tell you, Allah is the most forgiving, the most merciful, right? Do the sin and ask Allah to forgive you after. And even if you do that, I will never ever tell you to lose hope in the mercy of Allah, because Allah has said, never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Have mercy in Allah and still seek forgiveness. But brothers and sisters in Islam, shaitan might guarantee for you that Allah will forgive you after the sin. But shaitan cannot guarantee for you that you will have life after the sin to seek forgiveness, to be forgiven. So don't fall into a false sense of hope. At the beginning of today's moment, I said the scholars of tafsir, they say that this ayah is the ayah of hope, but not an ayah of false hope. So this ayah is not a license to do sin, but it's a license to pull us out of sin. I love you all for the sake of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. For indeed Allah is the one who pardons, and He loves to pardon, and we ask Him to pardon us, to forgive us in such a perfect way that our sins are effaced. And wallahi, this is the reality of how Allah forgives us, because from the names of Allah is Al-Afu, and Al-Afu refers to the one who effaces your sin. Meaning after you do it, He forgives you in such a perfect way that even the angel that witnessed the mistake is made to forget. The ink that has logged the mistake is lifted. The ground upon which you made the mistake is made to forget. You are forgiven in such a way as if you didn't make the mistake and the sin in the first place. And when you get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's nothing for you to answer for, and no one has any recollection of you having to answer for anything. La ilaha illallah. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Until next time, salamullahi alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuh.